Good evening, my name is Aditya. Today again we are back at the Opus, and today we will again be discussing some more important current affairs related to your CLAT exam. Today we are going to discuss one of the topics which is very, very important in terms of your CLAT exam, and that topic is the Olympics. We will be discussing the Olympics and the Paralympics differently. So we will be having two videos. In the first one, we will be talking about the Olympics. In the second one, we will be talking about the Paralympics and whatever remains from the Olympics. The reason why we are making a video differently for Paralympics is that India has won a lot of medals, maybe 17 medals. So it becomes very important for us to study about the Paralympics also, because it has been a record-breaking achievement for India this time. So we'll start with the Olympics, and there'll be some very important things when we start with the Olympics. The first thing you need to know about the Olympics is the history of the games, okay? That is a very important part. And as you know, the Olympics which we have these days, that is the modern Olympic Games. So the first kind of Olympics which actually happened, through which this concept came into being, was the ancient Olympics. We'll talk about that first. So the ancient Olympics, it was held in Greece from 776 BC to 393 AD. This was when the ancient Olympic Games were held. And the first modern Olympics, it was started in 1896. The first modern Olympics in 1896, and it was started in Athens, Greece. This was the first edition of the Olympics in Athens, Greece. Very important to know the difference between these two. If they ask you regarding the ancient Olympics, then your answer should be this. If they ask you about the modern Olympics, then your answer should be this. These are the two important things. Apart from this, you should be knowing about the man who, because of whom we are playing the Olympics these days. I'll just move this aside just a minute. Okay. So yeah. So we should be knowing about the man who did the Olympics. So the man is known as Baron Pierre de Coubertin. This is the name of the man. He founded the International Olympic Committee, the IOC as it is commonly known, 1894, 2 years prior to the first games. Okay. Now, just before I move ahead with this, I want you to know something about the International Olympic Committee. That is the first thing you should be knowing, is that it is headquartered in Lausanne, Switzerland. Okay. And the second thing which you should be knowing about the Olympic Committee is that the current chairman or president of the committee is Thomas Bach. And the third thing maybe which might be important is that if you ask me what is the primary language of the International Olympic Committee, that is not English but French. So it becomes very important for you to know this as well. Okay. Next. These are some important things with regard to the history of the Olympics. I think if you know this much about the history, this will do it for you. You don't need anything else apart from this. So, like I was telling you, that in terms of Tokyo 2020, we need to know something, that the Tokyo 2020 Olympic Games, they were one of the games which got postponed, okay. So, since the games got postponed, it becomes important for us to know that, is there any event in history, is there any Olympics in history which was postponed or which was cancelled? So, I don't think there is any Olympic Games which was postponed earlier. However, three of the games were cancelled. We'll talk about them. 1916 in Berlin, 1940 in Tokyo, this is also known as the Missing Olympics, okay. After after this there was the 1944 games, which was postponed as well, which was supposed to take place in London. So these are the three games which were postponed previously, and one of them was cancelled initially, and one of them was in Tokyo. So that becomes important. You should be knowing about this primarily. And apart from that, one thing which I can tell you regarding these Olympic Games is that these Olympics, all of them, they were cancelled due to World Wars, World War I and World War II. Okay. So these are some things which we should be knowing when we are talking about the Tokyo Olympics. I'll just let this remain here. We'll move to the next page. Okay. When we move ahead, we'll be talking about some more things related to the history. Okay. Like I told you, first games to be postponed, that was 2020, first ever game to be postponed. Some more things which we should be knowing, I'll make that simply easier, okay. Okay, so if they ask about the logo of the Olympics, you should be knowing that these are the five colors which make the logo of the Olympics. So they are namely black, red, green, yellow, and blue. These are the various colors of the rings of the Olympics. You should be knowing this. Apart from this, one more thing which you should be knowing is the motto of the Olympics. The motto of the Olympics reads as Citius Altius Fortius. Okay. This is the motto of the Olympics, but more important than this is the meaning of the motto. The meaning of the motto basically reads faster, higher, and stronger. So this is the motto of the Olympics. You should be knowing about this as well. Very important. Apart from this, I will also help you with this diagram. I will tell you some more things. Basically, the rings represent five continents. I'm just writing them down. Africa, Asia, America, Europe, and Oceania, which basically comprises of Australia and New Zealand primarily. Okay, so these are the five nations which you should be knowing about as well. Apart from this, one more thing I'll tell you, that just for the sake of knowledge, the first Paralympics was held in 1960 and it was held in Rome for the first time. So it started almost 64 years later than the original Olympics, which started in 1896. Okay, so this is mostly about the history. If you see the first page and this page, these two pages basically translates about the history of the Olympics. Next, we'll move forward to the next part regarding the Tokyo Olympics. Okay, so the Olympics took place in 2021, in August, towards the end part of August. But one thing which we need to know about this year's Olympics is that you don't call it Olympics 21, you call it Olympics 20. Because the Olympics was postponed, and even after the postponement, the brand of the Olympics, they did not change. It was called the Tokyo 2020 Olympics and not the Tokyo 2021 Olympics. Becomes very important for you to know this. Okay, next. This is the first ever Olympic to be postponed. First ever to be postponed. And first ever to be postponed or cancelled due to reasons other than war. This was the first Olympic to be postponed because of a pandemic and not a war. first time ever in the history of Olympics. Okay, now, so this somehow relates to the coronavirus pandemic also. You should be knowing about the earlier editions which were held in Japan. Like I told you, in 1940 there was an edition which was supposed to be held, however it was not held, and in 1964 one edition of the Olympics was held in Tokyo. Okay, very important for you to know this. Okay, like I told you, the 1964 edition was held in Tokyo. 1940 was supposed to be held in Japan, but it was cancelled because of the World War. So these are some editions which you may know in reference to the Tokyo Olympics 2020. Let's move this aside. Next, we'll be talking about some more important things with regard to the Tokyo Olympics. One of them is the motto. The motto of the Tokyo Olympics reads as "United by Emotion." You should be knowing this. This is the motto of the Tokyo Olympics, "United by Emotion." And apart from that, the mascot of the Tokyo Olympics is Someti. And there's a mascot for the Paralympics as well, but that we'll be discussing when we do the Paralympics. Okay. Next is, the Olympics was opened by the Emperor of Japan, since Japan has an emperor, as you are aware. Emperor of Japan, Emperor Naruhito. This is the emperor who opened the Olympics. Okay, who opened the Olympics, who started the Olympics in the opening ceremony of the Olympics. Apart from this, okay, now one more very important thing. Like I told you that the Olympics in Japan was the second Olympics in Japan, since one of them was held earlier in 1964. However, the Olympics in Japan was the second Summer Olympics in Japan, because four Olympics have been held in Japan in total, including Tokyo, obviously, Tokyo 2020. So two of them were Summer and two of them were Winter Olympics. Okay, so you should be aware about this. And since I have told you the Summer editions, I will tell you the Winter editions now. The Winter editions were held in 1972 and 1998. In 1972, the edition was held in Sapporo, and in 1998, the edition was held in Nagano. These are the cities where the Winter Olympics were held, okay? And both the Olympics, which were the Summer Olympics, they were held in Tokyo itself, okay? Next. Next, we'll be moving to the fact that Tokyo 2020 again is a important reason for us to know one thing. I'll just write it down here. This is the first Asian city to host two Summer Olympics. First Asian city to do so. So that becomes very important for you to know. Okay, next. There were some new games which were introduced this year. Every year new games are introduced. Some are added to the list and some are just added because of the host nation, because the game is popular in the host nation. So I'll tell you about the games. They were karate, sport climbing, skateboarding, and the final one was surfing. Okay, these are some other things which you should be knowing about the Tokyo Olympics. Apart from this, I think there are some more things which you should be knowing. We'll come to that now. Okay, one last thing before I change the page. Okay, so as you know, Russia has been banned from the Olympics. Okay, I'll reduce the size. Okay. So as you know, Russia has been banned from the Olympics, okay? So Russia is not allowed to participate in the Olympics. However, Russia's contingent was given a chance to participate in the Olympics, and it was known as ROC, or the Russian Olympic Committee, okay? So it becomes very important for you to know this as well. Okay, we'll move to the next slide. Okay. So now we'll be talking about medals in this Olympics. Becomes very important to know about some of the medals given in this Olympics. The first thing which you should be knowing is which country had the highest medals. It was USA. They had the highest medal both in terms of golds, which were 39 golds, and they had a total of 113 medals. And closely in second place was China, and it had 38 golds, but I don't think you need the exact distribution for China. You just need to remember for the first one, that is very important. Secondly, you should be knowing for the third one as well, because of a certain reason, that Japan finished third, and Japan had its highest ever medal tally in the Olympics this year. Highest ever medal tally. So that is why it becomes important for you to know about Japan also. Next. I'll just write down their medal tally because it might be important. 58 medals, out of which 29 were golds. Okay. Not 29, sorry, 27 were golds. Okay, yeah. Next. When we are discussing about the medal distribution, we should also know about the some firsts in the medal distribution. Firsts. So these countries for the first time won medals. That is Burkina Faso. Next is Turkmenistan. And after that, it's San Marino. These are the three countries which won medals for the first time ever in the Olympics. So it is very important for you to know about that as well. And after this, you should know about the youngest to win a medal. Okay? Youngest to win a medal. The youngest to win a medal at Tokyo, she was just 12 years old. Just 12 years old. And her name was... As you know, her name was Hiraki Kokona. She was from Japan. Hiraki Kokona. And she won a silver in skateboarding. Skateboarding, as you know, it was a new game. You should be knowing about this as well. And finally, the last thing which we'll be talking about is this person, the person who won the highest medals. Highest medals at this year, at this year's Olympics, the highest medal at this year's Olympics, and as you know, it was a person from the US, and the name was Celeb Dressel. Celeb Dressel, he won 5 medals for the USA, and all of these medals, they were in swimming. All these medals were in swimming. Okay, so these are some things which you should be knowing about the medals in the Olympics in general. The medals in the Olympics in general in various sports. I don't think you need anything apart from this because you cannot remember the medals for each and every sport. And apart from this, there is a last part we will be discussing in today's video. After that, we'll be done. That is India at the Olympics. India at this year's Olympics. Okay. So something which you need to know very importantly is that India fielded its biggest ever contingent at the Olympics this year. India has never sent so many athletes to the Olympics, and this was its biggest ever contingent, which comprised of 228 members. So that is very important. Some more things which you should be knowing before coming to the medals is the opening ceremony and the closing ceremony. Okay. So in the opening ceremony, the people who represented India were Barry Cohn and India's hockey captain, who is also known as Manpreet Singh. Apart from this, in the closing ceremony, India was represented by, or India's flag bearer was Bajrang Punia. Okay, and I think you know their sports, so I don't really need to highlight it. This is wrestling, this is boxing, and this is hockey. Okay. So, needed, you might have to know the weight category if they did something in the Olympics. All that thing is important. Okay, so that is something you should be looking at when you are talking about India at the Olympics. Now we will be talking about India at the Olympics, particularly in terms of medals. Okay, so let's get to that. India at the Olympics, particularly in terms of medals. So in this was India's best ever Olympics. 4 bronze, 2 silver and 1 gold medal, 7 medals in total. Previously India's highest haul was 6 medals. And it had come in the London Olympics. In the 2012 London Olympics. Okay. Now we'll be discussing about all the medals in specific. Next, when we talk about the medals specifically, now we'll be going in the order of bronze, then silver, then gold. Okay, so let's start with the bronze first. India won 4 bronze. Okay, the 4 candidates who won bronze. Okay, one was Lavlina Borgohain. Okay, next one was Indian men's hockey team. Next one was PV Sindhu. And the last one was Bajrang Punia. Lavlina Borgohain, you should be knowing that she is in the boxing arena and she is from Assam. These are some things you can know about her. Regarding the men's hockey team, you should be knowing that they defeated Germany in the bronze medal match. Okay? Like I have already told you, they are captained by Manpreet Singh. And with this bronze medal, India has the highest medals in the hockey event in Olympics, and it has overtaken the previous highest medals of Germany, and it has total number of medals highest ever, okay, across the Olympics. Total medals in hockey is highest. And one more thing which maybe you should know is that India won a medal in the hockey event after 41 years. Okay, the last one in 1980. And some more thing which is related to this is that because of these reasons, the Rajiv Gandhi Khel Ratna, is now known as Major Dhyan Chand Khel Ratna. This is the highest sporting honor in the country. Next, in terms of PV Sindhu, you should just know that she competes in badminton because there is no category in badminton. She won the women's singles bronze. Okay, and for Bajrang Punia, the fact that you should be knowing is that he's in wrestling. He's also from Haryana. Okay. And the last thing which you should be knowing about Bajrang Punia is his weight category. And the weight category in which Bajrang Punia competes is 65 kilograms. Okay. I will not ask you to remember the exact person who he defeated because that might not be important because he won a bronze medal. Next, we go to other things. Let's get back to that slide itself. We'll do it there. Next, we'll be talking about silvers. 2 silvers. Okay. One is Ravi Dahiya. Okay, so India won 2 silvers. And one silver from first was from Ravi Dahiya from Haryana, and he competed in wrestling. And the second silver was Meerabai Chanu. Meerabai Chanu, okay. We'll talk about their weight categories and sports now. So, if we talk about their weight categories and sports, this is 57 kg, okay. this is 49 kg. This is wrestling, W for wrestling. Wrestling, and this is weightlifting. Okay, and maybe you should know the people who defeated them also. So I'll tell you about that as well. The person who won the first prize is So the person who won the first prize in 57 kg wrestling is Zabur Uguyev. Okay, and this guy, he is from Russia. And the person who won the first prize in weightlifting 49 kg category is ZH Hao from China. Okay, these are some things which you should be knowing with respect to the silvers. Okay. Last part actually, gold. The gold was won in javelin by Neeraj Chopra. Javelin by Neeraj Chopra from Haryana. That is the only thing you need to know about the gold, and you can also know that this is Independent India's first gold in athletics. This is Independent India's first gold in athletics. Okay, India had previously won medals in athletics, but that was in 1904 when India was not independent and under British rule. So this is all you need to know. And if you want to know about an individual who won gold before him, that is Abhinav Bindra, but he had won it in shooting. Okay, that was not in athletics, that was in shooting. Abhinav Bindra. Beijing Olympics. Okay, that is pretty much it about the Olympics first part, and nextly we will be going to the Paralympics next day, and we will be trying to see if we have missed out something in the Olympics also, and we will be covering the same in the next video when we will discuss about the Paralympics. Well, that is it for today. I hope this was informative enough. See you next time on the next video. Please like, share and subscribe the video as much as you can. Thank you guys.